Hello and welcome. I'm Amritanshu Rai, and you're watching Constitutionally Yours on Raj Sabha TV from this beautiful campus of Tripura High Court in Agartala. In this program, we attempt to demystify the provisions of the Constitution. In this episode, we will take up the subjects mentioned in the state list of the Constitution, which is the sole responsibility of the state government for purposes of governance. Joining me in this endeavor are a distinguished panel of guests. I have with me Justice S.C. Das, former judge of the Tripura High Court, nominated by the Chief Justice of the Tripura High Court. I have with me Deputy Speaker, Mr. PABITRA. He has been nominated by the Speaker of Tripura Legislative Assembly. And I also have with me Mr. SUDIP Roy BARMAN. He is the leader of the single largest party in the Legislative Assembly of Tripura, and he is from the Trinamool Congress. And in the audience, we have bright students from the Tripura Government Law College who will be putting up questions to the panelists. Straight away to the subject. The state list subjects like agriculture, land, law and order, fisheries, industry, and local roads. Has the functioning of this system for the last 7 decades yielded results? Do the states require more subjects, and does the center need to be tasked with more subjects for better growth of the entire region? That's how we will begin, and I will open up by asking you, sir, what has been your experience, the way the subjects of governance in the state have been handled by the state government?
The state subjects are, therefore I was trying to say a few words, that our constitution is a living document. It has already made a journey of 70 years around. And the democracy is perfected in India. In the federal system, the state government and the central government are working together. There is cooperation and coordination between the central government and the state government. The powers to be exercised by the union and the state has been classified by the constitution, and accordingly exercised by the state legislature as well as the parliament. There is as such no issue which has come up for the consideration at the political level that the state is required to be more empowered on any other subject. At least that sort of thing did not come before the court during the long journey of my judicial career. So I would like to say that what is perfected during this long journey of our nation, I think it is all right. The law, what is there in the constitution, it is managing the union as well as the state government, and there is as such no major conflict on it.
So the state list, the subjects that are there in the state list, have we been able to get where we aspire to get? What has been the lag and what could be the reasons?
See.
In terms of development, growth, because these are all goals and targets for the state governments to achieve.
See, in my view, we are here in this state. Most of this next generation is not. But so far as I am concerned, I was born in the then East Pakistan. So when we came over here to reach Agartala from my native place, it would take 1 day. But now the development is there. Whichever government was there, they are trying for the development. But I can't exactly say that with all sincerity that the development has been at the pace which ought to have been there. Great, that might be. Might be there are some lapses here and there, but development is there.
Sir, I would get you in on this. The, being part of the executive, sir, and being part of the ruling party, what is your assessment of the various subjects that are there with you for legislation, for governance? Where do you think you would place yourself?
Our constitution is a very large constitution of the world. And our democracy also a very big democracy in the world. When we take up this constitution, autonomy of the states, it should be there. And but there should be a binding of the union. For that, from several times, some question raises from the states, oh, you want more autonomy. For that, one Sarkaria commission was formed. How can you develop the state subjects more active and for the development of the sake of the states, it should be given. That time it is discussed that bearing three subjects, finance, defense, and foreign affairs. All subjects should be gone to the states. It will be the better power for the states. But one clause should be there. If any states go beyond their limit, center can intervene.
Mr. Barman, your point of view on this, do you really agree? See, we've got one perspective which says that the development is yet to get to that level. There is a second perspective which says that we need more powers and more autonomy as the on the executive side. On your, according to you, do we really need more powers for the state, or is that enough? And we should the state should do much more in the existing subjects that they have.
No, first we should really make a realistic approach toward this. As defining the constitution, the powers that are vested to the state, whether we have successfully implemented them or not, there's the basic question. Does the government in the state have that will, have that mentality to really achieve that goal, which has been well clearly defined in the constitution? Now, to say that or to illustrate that, the government of Tripura, so far as agriculture, horticulture, fishery, animal resource department, in the year, if I'm not mistaken, 2001 and 2, there was a 10-year perspective plan, how we should really be self-sufficient on agriculture, in horticulture, in fishery, and in animal resource development. After completion of 10 years, there was an extension of time. That too elapsed, but we couldn't reach that goal that has been targeting since 2001 and 2002. Why that is happening, why we had to get fish from other states of the country, why we had to import fish from Bangladesh, Why are we, in spite of the 10-year perspective plan, why should we get in food grains? Why eggs will come from other states? Mm-hmm. Why will draw milk from other states? Mm-hmm. All this, why our meat is insufficient? All these things, really we haven't achieved that goal which was set. Now, why is it so? That's a big question. It merely depends on the will of the government, those who are running the show, whether they are sincere to their task or not. Mm-hmm. That's a big question. As long as you don't set up a normative vision, as long as your willpower doesn't allow you to reach that goal, the state will never achieve or reach to that target. Whatever has been imposed by this list 2 and also a part of in concurrent list, I think particularly, and I don't agree with Mr. Kaur, that even if we're more empowered, we might do something astonishingly, something good. I don't agree upon that. Whatever is well defined in the Constitution, if we are sincere to our task, I think the goal set or the target to be reached, we can reach provided there is a willpower of the government.
We'll open up the floor for questions. The first question.
Tell us about some state's initiatives in setting up more IT industries in our state.
That's practically in our states. We take up the IT first in our government sector. Now, when I was in the executive, I am drilling the IT ministry also at that time. In our government, practically in the entire northeastern states, we set up a secretariat lane. It should be connected to the center. And we, IT directorate has established there. But at that time, some lapses are there. Many big giants, big companies, they are not coming for the infrastructure of our states. As of now, Government of Tripura, with the help of the STPI, they have established one center in our IT directorate. Then it is now the time the big giants can come and we can develop more IT friendly. And now it's a very good subject for the nation. Without that, we cannot go ahead. It's a developing state.
So there's
we'll introduce it now.
Yes, there's a vision of the new Prime Minister, which is on digital India. Is Tripura being able to digitize most of the panchayat level and block level and the tribal communities? Has the digital thing penetrated to that level, sir? Very quickly.
It is a very good question, but it is a part of the Government of India. The BSNL and other organizations who are making the infrastructure in the states, it is by them. Still, all of our blocks are not covered by the network.
So the network has not...
Network not
you would like to respond to that very quickly. Why, that's not been able to happen?
No, what I think...
And is center to be blamed for that?
Not really. We in the opposition have been urging the government of the state to really give more importance in the IT sector. That's the place where we should have given thrust long ago. But very recently, especially after that broadband connection, high-speed internet connectivity through Cox's Bazar, we have inaugurated a building probably which has not yet started functioning.
No.
We have failed to allure the IT industries by giving good incentives, providing free space and other lucrative incentives to really invest over here. Probably that's the place where we have literally failed. And in spite of that high-speed internet connectivity that is made available through Cox's Bazar, which happens to be the third gateway, we have really, I think, as of now, we are lagging behind and probably we have missed the opportunity. Because, again, that point I would like to say, because the government probably doesn't have a clear vision.
Vision of it. Sir, you would like to just ask, would you like to respond or add to the whole thing quickly, sir?
Tripura is a small state in a remote corner of the country. And the resources are actually not enormous. In our judiciary, we are in the high court and in the district courts, almost all the district courts and high courts are, we have achieved e-court project implemented. And we are all the high courts, the Tripura has shown some of the prominence in the eco project.
So my experience has been the days that I've been here in Tripura, I have nowhere been out of network. Yes, there have been call drops, yeah, but I'm still on the data network, right, and it. Right. But I haven't traveled to the rural areas. So on that note, we'll take a short break and we'll be back with more questions from our law students here. Time for us to head into a break. Welcome back. So we'll take the next question.
So if the owner of a private land is not fairly compensated by the government who have taken his land for improvement, then what he will do?
The law in respect of this Land Acquisition Act. And now a new law has come into force. So previously there was, if some land has been acquired, then there was a process to be
followed.
And after following the process as a whole, actually land has been acquired. There are some disputes here and there, such as the Pradhan Mantri Sharak Yojana or something like that, in these sorts of, in village rural areas, where the fund is flown for construction of the road, but not for acquisition of the land. And in some, out of those disputes, there are some cases in the High Court also, and in the subordinate judiciary also, there are some cases. And in those cases, when the private land is occupied and that has been proved, then court has directed to pay the compensation as per the market rate.
So you've got your answer. So the matter has to come to court, and the court will give relief wherever such issues.
Law is not handicapped in this respect.
Correct.
Law is taking its own course.
Course.
For giving the
next question.
What sort of measures has been taken for road safety, where we can see that accidents are taking place due to poor conditions of the road?
We have taken up this. Mainly now the problem of the government is, as per our specification of the roads, our city is a very small city. The number of vehicles are more and more. We deport the laws. We deport the traffic and police personnel adequate. But some accidents taken places, mostly every day, some life also lost here. We are now, government has taken very stringent measures to make this accident should be minimized. And for the road safety, some measures have taken up to practically enforce the law first, then to educate the drivers and the students and the personnel also. How can they move?
So the road infrastructure is not up to the mark in Tripura.
Yeah.
That is a concern. But Mr. Barman, would you like to respond to that? Are you really satisfied with that kind of an answer?
No. One is to ponder, really, as to why Tripura leads so far as road accidents are concerned. Such a small state. The main reason is, what I feel, there isn't any planning how to combat the situation. How you should check the speed, or how you should penalize those who break the laws, those who really drive very
hard. You're talking of traffic policing.
Absolutely, traffic policing. And accidents are, of course, everywhere it is supposed to, likely to take place. But you'll be astonished to learn that we do not, as of now, we do not have a trauma center in the entire state. There is no ambulances. Mm-hmm. Everywhere you go, you will find, when you travel in the national highway, in case of accident, call the police this number and the ambulance in this number. Everywhere you find those, all the signboards being fixed. You travel across from here to the national highway to the south, to the north, never ever you will see any sort of signboard being fixed or any ambulances or any sorts of measure being adopted by the state government. Mm. All these people are all set to, you say, most of the people die due to road accident. You lose your vital portion of your body.
It's rampant.
It's really rampant.
Because the traffic system is not managed.
Each and every day we are having innumerable number of accidents where we doesn't cope up with the situation.
Next question.
Sir, here, heavy shower, it floods here. Sir, what is the state's view over this filling up of ponds and sewage system here, sir?
It creates some problem. It's fact.
Yes, sir.
But we are taking up this matter, improving. Earlier, 2-3 hours stagnation of water in Agartala city. But this time, you see, when one day the stagnation of water is there, on 2 days, there is 500, near about 40 millimeter rainfall is there. In 2 days. But last year, in the June month itself, there is a rainfall is 432 millimeters. You have seen the Ladakh, one cloud was broken. Just this year, rainfall is much more in the month of July, earlier in the year. Some problems are there, but still, should take up this drainage system. Agartala city is just like a pond.
Sir, your government has been there on the seat for several years.
Yeah.
You have known this problem, sir.
Now, for that, we are taking measures. We covered all drains. Main problem is there practically the persons who are inside the city, they are putting the plastics to the drains. For that, if you covered all, then it should be restricts them. And some lessons today. We have already municipal corporation has taken up 3 buckets. One degradable, non-gradable, and plastics. If we put separate, then it can be easily.
But to train the people and make the citizens aware is a challenge.
Yeah, yeah.
That's where
the people.
Mr. Barman, you want to add to that?
For the drainage system to improve, you ought to have a master plan. Our city is rapidly extending. Ask the executive whether, as of now, they have any master plan for Agartala city. The answer is no. The construction of drains depends on the wishes and whims of the non-technical person. I am a member of Legislative Assembly. From my Vidhayak Ilaka Unnayan Prakalp, I construct drain. I propose the drain to be constructed. Now, whether there is any scientific
application of mind, a policy.
What? We construct drains, people are satisfied.
But it creates problems somewhere else.
Somewhere else.
Yeah, yeah, I get it. It's a holistic plan. Do you think that's a major issue? The Tripura state needs to get a master plan into place, and they've not been able to do that.
See, one thing. As a citizen, I can say that our state is not on a plain land. Having a level everywhere, a same level everywhere. So the leveling of the entire city, Agartala
city. Like a bowl.
Like a bowl.
Ah.
So as a
result, water accumulates.
There must be a master plan.
There is a master plan issue.
There must be a master plan. This is the domain of the executive.
Exactly,
that is
exactly.
My respected brothers, they will look into it.
But there must be. This explanation of bowl has inserted in his brain also. Because this is a falsehood being repeated again and again. The simple answer to it.
That there is requirement for a master plan.
Absolutely.
We have make a plan there. You could see in the main city, our secretary is there. High court is there earlier. And all the major establishments in the city, in the small areas. But we diverted it, this new area, new capital complex. We have put our secretary here. We put our assembly here. We segregated the high court branch here. And now the most of the officials are now came to this northern side of our states, our city. For that, there is a plan is there.
Oh, so there is a master plan.
Yeah, yeah.
Why hasn't it been made public?
Yes, it is public.
That is actually this drainage system is concerned. The state government is now expanding the area of the Agartala municipality also has expanded. But the question is that even after a small rainfall also, That is, I see that in my house, there are three stairs in the, but it has now only one stair because the road level has been increased, drain has been gone upwards.
And the houses remain at a lower level.
Earlier, what used to happen, there are a lot of ponds, there are a lot of vacant areas where the rainwater, excess rainwater would accumulate.
We have legislated that all these ponds will not be filled.
But there is rampant filling.
Rampant filling above the ponds.
And gaining
where
land.
The excess rainwater were supposed to go to these ponds and lakes and other places.
Now there is no vacant space. Though we have legislated.
But with.
It's
I don't
complete
know,
violation, of,
violation of this law.
Next question.
Sir, how much allegation of share is given to ADC company established like ONGC, NIPPO, another various company established company in ADC area?
The share of taxes?
Yes, share of allegations.
Yeah, it is already given.
How much? Percent?
From how much I cannot say as of now. Now, as per the
what's the percentage, rules, roughly, sir?
Now, roughly, the as per the population, as per the area, where the ONGC's drilling site is there. What revenue earning by the from ONGC, government make the share and give it to the ADC. And when NEPCO is working there, it is also given to them.
So basically, the percentage that is come that comes in as profit or royalty from ONGC and other
the
natural share, resource extraction.
Share of taxes as per the rules we are given to the ADC.
But, I mean, where does it go? Does it go into the hands of the district administration or does it go into the hands of the ADC?
It is going to the Autonomous Area District Council Authority.
Authority. So is that happening?
No. I have gone through the details of budget at a glance and also the details expenditure budget. Nowhere this share of taxes goes to the ADC. Mm-hmm.
It is not correct. It is already given. Mm-hmm.
What they do is, though it is an autonomous body, it has to depend on the state government.
For funds.
For funds. Mm-hmm. Now, there has been a growing demand that the fund be directly sent to the ADC from the center. Why this demand has grown up? Because 3/4 of the area comes under TTA ADC. And you'll be astonished. Their budget is less than Agartala Municipal Corporation budget. The 3/4 of the land area is under TTA ADC. But their budget is less than that of Agartala Municipal Corporation. And by this act of this government, there has been a growing demand of, though we oppose, there's a growing demand that we require a separate Tripura land.
Okay. So that's where the problem is. There's no satisfaction on the ADC side as far as the revenue is concerned.
I don't know about it.
No, but there must be cases that must have come to you.
See, no such case is pending in the High Court. So long I was there, there was no such case came before me. The point is that regarding share of revenues and taxation, etc., there is clear provision in the 6th schedule. And regarding budgeting also, it is first discussed in the district council. Then district council places its requirement and its resources, etc. And thereafter it is made to the state government and the state is to place it in the annual financial statement, that is in the budget. Mm-hmm. So that is the process, the whole process. Now, actually, this regarding any revenue, the share of revenue, that is how much it is given or not, that is not, I am not okay. Actually.
That, on that note, that's all we have for you in this show. We'll be back with a new issue and a new program. Keep watching Rajya Sabha TV.